There we go, we're back. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the last episode, because right now we're about to figure out if this girl's mom is still alive or not on top of this building. And also we're almost dead. What an epic like journey it's been so far. So yeah, I'm enjoying this game so much. I already have. Go across, let's go. And so since this is gonna take a while, so let's talk about something else. Earlier today, I was watching the comment sections of different, you know, videos calling this game, you know, bad stuff. But and people were comparing this game to Tomb Raider and to Uncharted, and I'm thinking like, this game is nowhere even close to those games, like nowhere. I will compare this game to Far Cry, even though it doesn't have any cars in this game. Like, I will compare it because that's as close as you get. Like, what the hell is going on? Oh, what the? No way. Oh my god, I fell off again. I fell off. Damn it. Now I have to go back again. Oh, oh, easy. I know where to go. What's this? I didn't even see this. Whatever. It's just an audio log. Back to where we were. Like, a lot of people were comparing this game to like Uncharted, Tomb Raider, and that's it. And people are saying like it's a ripoff. And I'm saying to those people right now, like, this game is miles ahead of it. Like, it's way better. And I know. Wait, where were we? Where were we supposed to go? Up here? Where are we supposed to go? Oh, I didn't see you there. So yeah, like, this game is way better. There we go. And I'm not saying that Tomb Raider was not a good game. I'm saying that like, this game just like, it has more, you know? Lot to offer, and also the graphics are amazing, the gameplay is amazing, the story, I mean, it's a little bit understandable if you pay attention to it, and you're not gonna get lost. You'll be good. Wait, what? It wants me to go through here. Yeah, it wants me to go. It wants me to go to the side here. You can keep climbing up, but I guess I'll go to the side. How far are we, anyways? Damn. I should have ended the video on the when I barely got here, too. Because, so far we haven't done nothing. We're just climbing a building. It's crazy. And like I keep saying, like, this is a good setting for Resident Evil, like the way the building looks for an after explosion or whatever, like this would have been awesome. Easy, easy girl, come on. Ooh. We're almost there? God damn. I'm gonna collect all these audio logs. Just like, look at them. Wasn't there a box here? No, no box. Thought I saw one.
The way up. All it takes is a few good handholds.
Where? What are you talking about? It was gonna happen at some point. Hopefully it doesn't spawn me all the way to the beginning. I'll be a little bit pissed. But man, oh man. Okay, we're here. I wonder why it wanted me to go like through here when I can keep on climbing up though. If we're still gonna end up climbing up the whole way. there you go. Like that's a lot easier than just going all the way around. Maybe the game doesn't want me to like climb up or something. Maybe there's nothing. I just climb up for nothing here. There you go, it made it easier.
The way up. All it takes is a few good handholds.
Oh, there it is, those damn bars. I didn't even see the bars. Okay.
Alright, made it. Wonder what we'll find.
Doesn't seem to be much. I got my health back.
All data has been erased from this device. Do you wish to deploy item privileges to recover purge data?
Oh yes, I believe I do.
The file has been recovered.
Scan the data point. Is that it? Oh. Wait, hold on. God damn it. I got stuck. I was like, what's going on here?
Elizabeth, good to, it's been years.
Where's your legal team, Ted?
No need. I dropped all 18 lawsuits the moment you landed. I assume your data confirms this.
All right, this promises to be interesting.
Perhaps we could have lunch brought in. You know, get reacquainted.
I know you, Ted. You've screwed something up, something big, or you wouldn't have eaten the crow necessary to get me here. So spit it out.
There's a glitch in the chariot line.
You're killer robots?
Peacekeepers, yes, those.
So shut them down.
Obviously, Liz, we would, if we could. They're not responding.
Are you telling me a swarm has gone rogue, Ted?
It's worse than that.
Show me the data then. And I'll take that lunch. Alone.
Ted Farrow brought Elizabeth Sobeck here. But they hated each other.
Another file has been recovered.
Is there another hologram going in?
This isn't a glitch. It's a catastrophe.
Fully aware. It's bad.
Bad?
Jesus, Liz.
It's not bad, Ted. It's apocalyptic. You built a line of killer robots.
Peacekeepers.
That consume biomatter.
Okay, should be working now. So hopefully you guys didn't miss out on a lot, because right now my HD PVR just turned off by itself. And I don't know why, but it just turned off. So I think I missed like around like 30 seconds of dialogue of what happened here, because you know, we're watching these holograms and all of a sudden just my PVR just decided to stop working, and that's what happened right now. So I do apologize for that, and hopefully we did not miss a lot. Right now they were just talking about, you know, some conflict that's happening in the land, and that's why this building ended up like this. So I'm pretty sure you guys didn't miss much. So enjoy the rest of the dialogue here with these holograms.
Catastrophe.
Fully aware. It's bad.
Bad?
Jesus, Liz.
It's not bad, Ted. It's apocalyptic. You built a line of killer robots.
Peacekeepers.
That consume biomass as fuel.
So they were supposed to be good guys, but that didn't come out right.
Limited self-manufacture controlled.
Not anymore. The glitch severed chain of command. The only nation this swarm answers to now is itself.
You think I did?
What?
Everything else is just food. And at the rate it's replicating, Ted, it will strip the Earth bare in 15
months. It was this guy's fault.
We're not talking fall of civilization. We're talking extinction.
I get it, Liz. So how do I stop it while it's contained?
It's not contained. It can't be.
They're robots, I mean.
Right. Before the truth gets out, you mean.
Liz, I will do anything you say. Keep working it, and whatever you recommend, I'll do.
I'm gonna hold you to that, Ted.
So that's the mother right there.
They kind of look alright.
Threatened all life on Earth, but somehow she defeated them. The world of the old ones fell, but life went on, or we wouldn't be here.
Whoa, it's a little bit glitchy here. Look at this. Look at Aloy's leg. That goes like through the ground. What's up with that? Scan the data point. Okay, so what's going on here? Apparently, this guy who was sitting down in the chair created the robots, and all of a sudden they just took over themselves. So that's some kind of Terminator Salvation kind of crap. And I'm saying it's bad. No, it's cool. You know, I like this kind of stuff. So it's all right. That's all right. How do I scan again? Wait. I am scanning. Oh, it's just a triangle, I guess.
Project yeah. Zero Dawn.
God, there's still more?
Jesus, Liz. There has to be another way.
If there were a nicer way to fix your mess, I would have proposed it.
But this?
This should be a better angle.
When I asked you to find a cure, I didn't expect it to be worse than the disease.
It's not, Ted. It may be grim, but it's our only chance. Now sign the proposal.
Sign it? I can't sign that.
Yes, you can.
That? Liz, I cannot in good conscience.
Who acts like this,
sign
though?
That.
You've got a choice, Ted.
How is she sitting there, though?
I am speaking to you from a VTOL en route to U.S. Robot Command.
I'm pretty sure this scene is a little bit glitched, though. I mean, look at that. I'm pretty sure she just...
Are you crazy?
Going on here?
Now your choice is what I tell them. Sign, and I'll tell them the wealthiest corporation on Earth has guaranteed the funds necessary to build Zero Dawn. Exactly as I've designed it. Or don't sign, and I will make sure they and everyone else on this planet knows the real cause of the glitch.
Jesus, Liz. You don't have to threaten me. I'll sign.
Okay.
Look on the bright side, Ted. From here on out, you get to do what you've always been good at. Footing the bill while others get their hands dirty.
God forgive me.
Dude, this thing is glitched, though. It was.
Your solution is so terrible.
No human can just, like,
stop the robots.
I don't know. So that's kind of, yeah, this is kind of like Terminator. Exit the ruin. Is there anything up here? Yeah, of course there's something up here. So this is interesting, to be honest. Like, it's like a better Terminator.
This doesn't add up. Sobek couldn't have been my mother. She lived ages ago. All this searching, and I'm still no closer.
That's your reaction to everything you've just learned? To whine like a spoiled child?
Oh, God.
You should really try talking that way to me face to face.
As you wish. Do you really have no idea how monumental are the discoveries you just made, Aloy? I expected more of you.
So, you have a face. Got a name to go with it?
Of all the questions you could ask right now, that's the one you choose. I've spent decades searching the ruins of the old ones, trying to solve the mystery of what happened to them. For years, I've suspected that feral robots destroyed their civilization, but I could never confirm it.
Wait, so this happened ages ago. How long was it? Like 1,000 years?
And what you want to know is my name. Silence. That's my name. Now, why don't you try asking another question? Something less trivial.
You have no idea what I've been through. How hard it's been. My whole life, I grew up not knowing who I am or where I came from, and then come the Eclipse trying to kill me just because I look like this Elizabeth Sobek woman.
And they killed the man who raised you and you found in the mountain as a baby. I already know this through your focus.
The point is, every time I take a step forward, the answers slip farther from my grasp. You just don't understand.
It's not that I don't understand, Aloy. It's that I don't care. If the answers keep slipping away every step you take, then you best start running to catch up. Maybe then you realize just how big your problems really are.
Well, the map is pretty huge, so...
You've chased a personal riddle into a crowd of larger mysteries. The common thread is your connection to Elizabeth Subic.
But what is that connection? She couldn't have been my mother if she lived centuries ago.
We don't know the connection yet. The only way to find out is to keep
might be her grandma
making discoveries. Thanks to you, we've only just now learned that Pharaoh robots once threatened to end life on Earth.
But it didn't happen. The Old One's civilization was destroyed, but life was saved.
Obviously. So, what did Elizabeth do? How did she stop the robots before all was lost?
What was Project Zero Dawn?
Exactly the question. Now, are you ready to go get the answer?
Of course I am.
Then why are you still standing here?
Because you're talking to me.
You're insufferable, you know that?
God.
What's going with this? Elizabeth told Ted Faro she was headed for a place called U.S. Robot Command to tell people about Zero Dawn.
The place still exists as a ruin. The Asuram call it the Grave Horde.
Grave Horde? Cheery name.
You'll find it in the Eastern Mountains, buried under the tangled coils of a metal devil, or a BOR-7 Horus, rather, as we're learning to call them. I'll contact you when you get there.
I can't wait.
Isn't that kind of creepy? I mean, the guy can see you through the damn thing. So at the time that you showered and went to the restroom and you wore that thing, he was looking at you. One creepy dude. Oh, shoot. There you go. Putting a little bit of Uncharted here. Well, I'll be damned. At least I'm not half dead. I'm just cold. I mean, she is like half naked, so.
Kind of cold there. Whee! Frost on my eyelashes.
I don't have anything else for you to wear. Sorry, Aloy. So yeah, that's pretty cool, you know. The story is pretty much well done. So go to the Grave Horde. Where is that at? Oh yeah, I was there. This is where I was off camera, like when I was searching for the parts for my costume, the one that I currently have. I was looking for the charger side, and I was like, you know, inspecting this whole area for this charger side, and then I went up a little bit more north just to get that flower, but I never found it. So yeah, that's our next destination, I guess. So we've been there already, and I fought some of these too. These are freaking take a while to kill. So one thing I want to do right now is look for the I'll just go around. Bye bye. Yeah, never mind. But yeah, it's a cool story overall right now. I'm surprised Heather hasn't played it. That's one of my YouTubers that I see here all the time. Like, I support a lot of small YouTubers. They're pretty cool. Hey, where's a big robot go? Oh my god, the robot left. I was gonna take a picture with it. Oh, that sucks. So I can just teleport out of here, that's a good thing. Okay, people. So that's the end of the episode. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the story and everything. And we'll go check out this one like later on, because I still got another quest though. And it's a main quest. It was the revenge of this other guy, the sister that died. I'm gonna do this one first since we're closest to it. So we gotta kill the machines and meet Aaron in the Ridge Pass. So I'm gonna do that one first. How far is that one? Pretty darn close. Okay. So this is gonna be our next episode, guys. Hopefully you guys subscribe for more, and also it's gonna be more Horizon Zero Dawn.